I wonder what's on TV.
Oh, this is a great idea, Simpson. Free silver dollars, compliments of C. Montgomery Burns.
That was a close one. Wanna go bowling?
Maybe you should see a doctor about that cord in your brain.
Maybe you should mind your own business. Afternoon, miss.
Oh!
Huh. That gives me an idea. I have some time tomorrow. Here I am, perched up above the Sears Tower. And I think I'm going to drop this penny on that innocent person walking by.
Somebody's dropping money on me.
Blimey! If only I had listened in physics class!
Believe it or not, but the question relates to terminal velocity and skydiving. At terminal velocity, the force of gravity down is going to be equal to the force of air resistance up. A skydiver in the layout position is going to be going about 120 miles an hour before the force of gravity equals the force of air. Now if we talk about a penny is going to have a tiny little force of gravity and therefore just a tiny little force of air resistance to cancel it out at terminal velocity, which is only 22 miles an hour.
We did a simple experiment using a protractor and a penny hanging from a string. We then observed the forces acting on the penny as it hung from the string outside the window of a moving car. There is the force of gravity acting in the vertical direction, which pulls the penny downward towards the earth. If the motion of the car, as shown in the diagram on the whiteboard, is taken to be to the right, then the force of air resistance must oppose this motion. Therefore, the force of air will push the penny to the left. The other force acting on the penny is the force of tension in the string. The force of tension keeps the penny from flying away. Thus, when the string makes an angle of 45 degrees with the horizontal, we know that the size of the force of gravity must equal the size of the force of air. Any other angle would indicate that either the force of gravity or the force of air would be larger than the other.
So here we are inside of the car, and I'm here with my partner, Mark.
Howdy.
There's the protractor. The penny is hanging right down there below. Okay, I think we're ready.
Okay, the penny's at about 45 degrees.
And it looks like we're at about 22 miles an hour.